So you go to your eye doctor and he does a dry eye or blepharitis evaluation. He sees that your lids and lashes are sick and not functioning the way they should. What are your options? What can you do? All right, so you go to your eye doctor, you've had some dry eye symptoms, or in a routine eye exam, your eye doctor will notice that your lids don't look like they're functioning the way they should. This is called blepharitis or meibomian gland dysfunction. When I talk to a patient about this, I talk about the four factors that are affecting their eyes. Number one is external inflammation. These are the things that are in the outside environment that your eyelids and eyelashes block from entering your eye. Number two is obstruction. The glands have to secrete the oil to keep your tear film healthy and functioning at its maximum potential. When they get obstructed, they don't produce that oil and your tear film is not protecting your eyes. The other two are inflammation internally. There's localized inflammation in your lids, also systemic inflammation from your gut, from the rest of your body can actually affect your eye. So once you look at those four factors, what can you do? Well, you can do nothing and that will actually cause death. Yes. Death of your meibomian glands. If they get inflamed or plugged up for too long, they drop out and this means they disappear. If you lose too many of those glands, you're not gonna produce the tears that protect your eyes. This is not only gonna affect your vision, but it can lead to scarring and damage of your cornea. So you don't want to do nothing. The next option is to do some home therapy. These are things as simple as lid hygiene. By cleaning your lids and lashes at night, you're reducing that external inflammation. Again, your eyelashes and eyelids are doing their job. You have to help them out by getting that debris off your lids and lashes. If it just sits there, it will cause inflammation, cause those glands to be obstructed. And that's what we'll address next is the obstruction. So clean off the debris, get rid of that external inflammation. Now we have to heat up the glands to get them to express. When they're plugged up for too long, the glands that secrete oil, well, it gets thick. It's almost like butter or margarine. So by heating it up, it helps it express and leave the gland. This will give you a better, more stable tear film, but also cause your body to upregulate. Upregulation means it's gonna make new, healthier oils. Well, this is where you need omega-3s. If you have omega-3s in your diet, tuna, salmon, mackerel, or supplement omega-3s that are high in EPA and DHA, about 2,000 to 3,000 milligrams, these are the building blocks of your tear film. So when your body upregulates, it's gonna pull all those omega-3s and make newer, better, healthier oils. The omega-3s actually will help a little bit in addressing that internal inflammation. Now, not to the extent that we need, but it's a step in the right direction. So by doing home therapy, we address the external inflammation, we address the obstruction, and we kind of address some of that internal inflammation. Now, the next step is doing the home therapy, but getting an in-office procedure. These are things like IPL, intense pulse light therapy, and low level light therapy. These are forms of a process called photobiomodulation. All that means is this causes your glands to be less inflamed. So you address that localized inflammation. In addition, we do heat therapy in the office as well as clean those lids and lashes. So it's everything you do at home on steroids with the addition of addressing that internal inflammation. Now, to get beyond the localized inflammation of your lids, you're gonna have to look at your overall diet. This is one of the biggest things that can help you address that systemic inflammation. You wanna eat things that are high in fiber. Look at adding a pro or prebiotic. These things will help your microbiota, your microbiome, your gut be healthier. By doing that, you can reduce the inflammation in your body, which can also reduce the inflammation of your eyes. So, like I said, these are the things that I'm looking at when I'm examining my patient's eyes, and these are the things that you can do to keep your eyes functioning at their maximum potential. So if you learned something new, give us a like, subscribe, we'll see you in the next video.